welcome to the Disneyville podcast, episode 16.
That's right. I am Jessica.
And I am tired.
We are very tired. It's like a rainy day while we're filming this. So we're literally like stretching our eyes open, like, come on. And we're also filming earlier in the morning than I think we ever, ever have. Usually it's like mid-afternoon.
Film, so we're just going to do some nice laid back vibes today.
Yeah, just if you you feel that this is a different vibe, it's because it is.
Coffee house jazz going on in the background, rainy windows.
All right.
So let's talk about what we're going to talk about.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
Top 10 snacks in Walt Disney World. And it's actually probably going to end up being between top 10 and 20, because we each have our own personal top 10.
That's right.
It's probably going to be some duplicates. So between 10 and 20 top snacks.
I bank on about 15 snacks.
Yeah.
So you can, you know, make your little list if you're going and you haven't tried any of these, or maybe you've never been and you're planning. I have to say, while I was creating my list this morning, I was so hungry. I told Tyler, I was like, I cannot possibly sit down without eating a bunch of food. Like, I need to be very full when we film this because it's too hard to talk about food. So if you're starting to listen to this and you're hungry, I'm so sorry.
Grab a snack now.
Yeah. Pull through a drive-through. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, here, let's do our mug shots.
Okay.
You start.
I'm trying to think if I've shown this in a podcast yet. I think I have. It's just one of my favorites. It's got all of the princesses on it. It's got Rapunzel and Cinderella, Tiana, Brave. Oh, my gosh. I sound like Genevieve.
Yeah.
Merida and Belle. So not all of them, but a lot of them. And it's light pink. I bought it in Disney, I think, last time we were there. This is definitely a recent purchase.
I think so, yeah.
Also could have not been... No, okay, it was Disney. I was like, maybe I bought it at like Meijer or just a random superstore.
Yeah, that does look like one. Yeah, you'd see it.
I think
Meijer.
I bought it at Disney.
Yeah.
I love it.
This one, I think, was the last time we went to Disney's, the one that I got. And it's the Toy Story clouds, which just make me so happy. It's just a blue mug with the Toy Story clouds. And then it says on the front, reach for the sky.
It's a goodie.
Advice from Icarus.
Good.
Okay.
Why too close to that sun? All right. So, all right. Come on. Energy up. Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to have a hot take here right off the bat.
Whoa.
Whew. Hot take.
All right. What?
The prettier the Disney snack, the worse it tastes. I feel like there's two schools of snacks in Walt Disney World. There's ugly and delicious, and then there's Instagrammy and gross. Not gross, but not good.
Medium. Medium.
So... if you see something that looks really cute and it'd be like really good in an Instagram photo, it's probably not going to taste very good. But if you see something that looks like maybe somebody already ate it and put it back on the plate, it's going to be delicious.
That is actually, I think there's a lot of accuracy to that. It's probably 90% of the time true. And like, okay, think about this. We're going to be talking about savory and sweet snacks, right? Like mine is a mixed list. Okay. But it's interesting because like, as I kind of look through this, I would say two or three of them are Instagram worthy. The rest of them do not photograph well. So for some of them, we'll pop up pictures if you're watching it on YouTube so you can actually see what we're talking about. Because I kind of went through and I found, I think, photos or videos of most of the things I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But you're right. A lot of the ones when you go in those bakery cases and they all look so beautiful and it's straight up art. Like what they create in some cases is just art. They taste fine, but they're not always...
You're buying that for the likes, not for the taste.
I don't know. Maybe we're wrong. Maybe you really, really like some of these things. But yeah, I'm just so curious to hear your list. Yeah,
and I'm also, I bet there's going to be some people that are going to be a little disappointed about what's left off of our lists.
Oh, I think so too.
So at the very end, I put what's not included. I have a little list.
I do too. Okay.
We haven't seen each other's list yet.
No.
And then, okay, so two other things.
And I'm intentionally like facing mine away so you can't see it. No
two
spoilers.
Other things. Only parks. So no resorts.
Yeah.
If we were doing parks... or if we were doing resorts, beignets would have been on that list so fast.
I know.
There's a few things that would have been on the list, but no resorts and no festival foods.
And no Disney Springs either.
Right.
But that could be a whole different...
Right, exactly, yeah. But these are foods that are available year-round, not just at one of the festivals, because that could be its own, like, best snacks of food and wine or whatever. But this is year-round snacks.
Yep. And the other thing that I was thinking about is two things. One... in our YouTube, I know a lot of you guys are just listening, but those that are watching, we try to put timestamps so you can click ahead. So like if you're like, maybe you stumbled upon this video and you don't even know who we are and you're like, I don't really care about what you have to say. I just want to hear the 10 snacks. We have a corresponding blog post. So you can check that out if you'd rather read it.
Welcome to Disneyville. Disneyville.com.
That's right. But we'll have it linked below. And we also have timestamps. So if you want to skip ahead to that and skip over our mumbo jumbo, you're always welcome to. It's okay. I get it. I'm not for everyone. You're not for everyone.
But now we're done with our mumbo jumbo. Let's get into
Yes. I had one more thing to say, but I cannot remember it. So there we go.
Okay. Must have been really important. Oh, we're not going into the Disney Dining Plan snack that was credit. It. So that's we talked about it, but we're not exactly sure because they haven't started yet. What's going to be included? What's not going to be included? Again, that could be one.
It'll change from past times. Yeah.
It could be a future episode. Like, what is a good use of a snack credit?
Oh, versus... 100% we will do that. A lot of these might be on that list, but... That's the thing. Yeah. We don't know what will count as a snack and what won't.
Right.
Some of these I know have in the past.
Right.
But I, again, it's been years, so who knows?
Okay. All right. Your number 10.
This is going to be controversial to you.
Wow. Okay.
Starting number 10 is the Wookiee cookie from Backlot Express.
I didn't love the Wookiee cookie.
Yeah. I just wanted to hear you say it.
It was too much. The Wookiee
cookie. Too much Wookiee, not enough cookie. So here's the thing. When we tried it in that vlog, I... liked it, but I was like, it's not a favorite. Like, it's a little bit too rich. We had milk because we'd gotten Felicity some milk for her bottle, and we also drank some of the said milk because it is very rich, the cream in the middle. It's basically two sugar oatmeal cookies, and I'm saying I think they're meant to be oatmeal cookies, but they taste more like a sugar cookie than they do an oatmeal cookie. And then there's like a cream filling in the middle. It's got like a little chocolate, like Wookiee, you know, sash
bar,
across it. Yeah. Very, again, this is one that is very Instagrammy, very cute. But I haven't stopped thinking about it. I want to sink my teeth into the cookies and then the cream and that texture. And it's weird because in the moment, we didn't even end up finishing it. We were splitting one. We gave some to Genevieve and we still didn't finish it.
Between three of us.
Between three of us. But now I'm like, all I want is to sink my teeth into one again. So yeah. I don't know what that means. So I had to put it on the list because I've been thinking about it.
Yeah. That's not surprising, though. You and I have very different ideas of what, like, good desserts are. Like, you love the, like, cream horns they sell at the grocery store that taste like nothing except, like,
cream and
cardboard and shaving cream, and you just love
you
them.
You are mistaken, sir.
Sir.
You add sugar to that with shaving cream, and then we'll talk. It's a croissant with cream in the middle. You don't understand good things. You don't understand good things.
Is it? We also have very different ideas of what makes good donuts. We are on complete opposite sides of the spectrum.
Yeah, because you like jelly-filled donuts. And I'm like, the jelly ruins the donut for me. I want literally anything else.
Yeah.
And but also, see, I'm a big fan of cream. So here we are again.
But the cream, I love like custardy creams. But if it's like a whipped cream.
Yes, please.
But I also loved whipped cream if it's like good whipped cream in
other
situations.
But that's not the same thing,
it's not,
know?
Yeah. So anyway, okay.
Well, I like it all.
We're going
to
talk about that another day. So my number 10 actually is one that I didn't know could be a snack until today when I was just doing a little bit of research.
Mm-hmm.
The peanut butter and jelly shake in Hollywood Studios. Apparently you can get in the Tune In Lounge. You can just walk up and get one of the Tune In Lounge in Hollywood Studios. I didn't know
that's
this.
That's a game changer. Because you don't have to go to the restaurant. What's the restaurant called? It's
50s,
the one
Primetime.
That's right.
So literally, I'm going through the whole list, and I've got nine. I'm like, gosh, what is my 10th one going to be? I could not think of a 10th one. And then I saw that I could do that as a snack. I'm like, oh, there we go. Done
looked
and
at,
done.
You looked in the rule book.
Done and done.
Oh.
Yeah.
Describe that shake. How would you describe it?
It is genuinely, I don't know what magic they do, but it is a peanut butter and jelly sandwich that they've somehow whipped with ice cream, I guess. I don't know. It's not at all how they do it. But it tastes like a peanut butter and jelly in a shake. It is so good. Now, when you get it, they have like the three separate things. Don't they? It's like three separate colors.
No, it's all white.
Is it all white?
That's
I couldn't remember.
That's incredibly
but
weird
then,
to me.
It tastes like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
I don't know how they do it.
Which doesn't even sound all that good, but trust me, it is.
It is good.
So good.
Better than you think.
Unbelievably good.
My mouth is watering yet again, and I'm not hungry. Oh,
we're
boy.
We're going to take an intermission here in a few minutes.
I'm still thinking about the fact that you can just walk on a hot day to go up and get that. That's one you could share, though, because, again, it is very rich, but it is very good.
It's kind of like the Wookiee cookie. Like, I feel like I'll take a bite, and that's enough for me. Like, I'll be like, okay, it's fine.
I just like hearing you say Wookiee cookie. It's so cute. It's like it's like you're six, and I don't know why. It's really cute.
Oh, my
God. Also, can we get an appreciation post for Tyler's shirt?
This is a birthday gift, and it's got Ratatouille on it, or Remy, and it's got Ratatouille ingredients all over it.
Literally, like, one zucchini, one red bell pepper, eggplant, salt.
And, like, the copper stock pot and
what
stuff like
that. What
was
this brand? It was like RSVLTS results or whatever. They had so many Disney-type shirts.
Yeah,
it was very
cool. This, I think, on Instagram, and I was like, well, I must own it.
They gotcha. Okay, my number nine. I feel like people sleep on the caramel corn in the Germany Pavilion at Epcot. We got it this last time, and I was like, yup, it's warm. It is so good. It reminds me of like Garrett's popcorn from Chicago. It's so good. And then you can walk around, you eat some of it, bring it back to your room, eat some the next day or later that night. Mm-hmm. It's one of those snacks that just keeps on giving.
Here's my one caveat to that. We've had it this last time, and it was amazing. We couldn't stop eating. So good. But we've also had it in the past, and it was really stale. It was already like a day old. So I don't know.
That was like 6 years ago.
It was a while ago.
So maybe that was just a weird.
If you see them making it, maybe it's fresh. And then, I don't know. I don't know how to solve that problem. But I will say in the past, I didn't like it. But this last time, it was so good.
Yeah. So maybe just do a vibe check. You know, like peek your head in. Be like, all right, what are we doing? Like,
do I smell fresh?
And I would bet, because I know they'll like pre-bag some. I would bet if you ask, like, can I get a fresh, like, bag? I bet they would.
Yeah. And they have some that are sitting out on tables, if I remember right. And then they have, like,
those
a
are,
line
like, pre-sealed, though. So
yeah.
I think maybe that's what we did. I wonder if we bought, like, the, I'm going to say factory made, but I don't know.
Yeah.
But those look like factory sealed, not like the bags you get.
I feel like, though, when you walk in, you can see them behind the counter making it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're like, hey.
Yeah.
So good. Okay.
So good.
So my number nine is one that we haven't tried in a long time, but I remember loving, was the cinnamon roll from Gaston's Tavern in Magic Kingdom. I remember, again, that was when it was so big. I think you and my mom and I split one. It was that big.
Yeah. And even so, I was like, I'm not sure I can finish this.
But it was really, really good. I remember liking it a lot. And it was warm. I think we even had an option to warm it up, and we did. Mm-hmm. And that was one that I really liked. I mean, it's just a cinnamon roll, but I remember.
You know what, too? The options for, like, quick service breakfast in Magic Kingdom is pretty limited. That's, I mean, that's, I would consider that a burger. It's like a Danish, if
they
you will.
They have, like, the Gaston's Tavern, Westward Ho, and the bakery on Main Street. That's, like, your only options for breakfast.
We'll have to do a quick service breakfast episode, again, far future, because we have really discovered some gems, and I feel like it's, if you start looking, it's really hard to find.
Yeah.
Like, unless you have a reservation or you're just at your resort, it can be hard in the parks to find breakfast. Yeah. So, but yeah, on that note, the LeFou's Brew, we didn't do any drinks on this. That, again, different, fill an episode with that. But LeFou's Brew, we got with that. And that together, because LeFou's Brew is kind of like a frozen slushy apple cider type drink. It's really good. But those together don't go well.
No,
it's kind of like when you, I think about like, okay, think about when you were a kid. If you went to church and there were like donuts after church and you'd get your OJ with your donut and that combo, you're like, why am I doing this to myself, 6-year-old me? But you do it anyway because you just, I don't know, you do. That's what it feels like to me. Although it'd be apple juice, but it's like drinking apple juice with it. And it's like, they're both sweet, but it's not the same sweet. No. So it's just, you need like milk or coffee with your cinnamon roll.
When I was a kid, I used to eat orange juice and burritos, like microwave burritos and orange juice. I don't know why. It was a thing that I did. Anyway,
did you dip them in the orange
juice?
No,
or? I just ate them together. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. You did that a few years ago. You were having a moment and you...
I tried it.
You were like, I can't, I'm going to do it tonight.
Yeah.
Like, all right.
Gross. Don't recommend. But anyway, it was the thing I did when I was a kid. So now you know a little bit more about me that you don't want to know. Yeah, the LeFou's Brew, I'm not a fan of. It's too sweet, I think. It's not, I don't know. I think when the Wizarding World of Harry Potter opened and Butterbeer became such a big thing, Disney was like trying to make fetch happen.
Yeah,
exactly. And that did not turn out.
It's just different though. I don't
feel like I hear anybody talk about LeFou's Brew anymore. Like it was like a thing for a while, but I think everybody tried it and they're like, no, I don't want it. Do you hear people talk about it very much?
Not as much, but there's just so much new. It's hard, you know.
Yeah.
When it was new, it was exciting.
Yeah.
Now, by the way, Butterbeer. Like an old cardigan, just put it under the bed. It's Taylor Swift, don't worry about it.
Okay, the Butterbeer, try it hot if you happen to go to Universal. We've tried it, the frozen and the hot. I love the hot. It's so good.
I love both.
Okay, your number eight.
Okay, my number eight was a new one, and this is another one that's Instagrammy, and I only have like three. The Seven Dwarfs ice cream cones at Magic Kingdom. They're at Storybook Treats, kind of right by Friar's Nook, like behind the castle. We got one this last time for Genevieve, and I think they change which character it is, but it's usually like a colored swirled soft serve and one of the dwarfs like a little white chocolate thing on top of it. They make it look like it's got a little belt buckle. It is very cute. It's soft serve, so if you like soft serve, you would like it. But I ended up helping her finish it, and it was really good, but it's also so cute. And if you're going to get soft serve anyway, why not get like a super cute one? Or maybe like a dollar or two more. I think you were not. You might have been at meetings or something.
Yeah.
It was very cute. That's I'll funny. Have to show you the picture.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, I'll have to look at that. Okay, my number eight is the ever elusive Pepper Jack pretzel. And it is elusive because it's never in the same place twice. It's never where you left it. So the first time I ever had it was at the lunching pad, and it has like jalapenos in it, and it's got like spicy cheese on top. It's not super spicy, but it just had a little kick to it.
And that was over in Tomorrowland.
That was in Tomorrowland. Then it was no longer there. Then it came back. Now it's gone again. It's been, I looked it up. It's been at like Harambe Market in Animal Kingdom. It was at a cart in front of Rock and Roller Coaster for a little while. It was at the Cheshire Cafe for a little while. Like, it's just, it's always, it's
that
like,
was, I think, the most recent iteration at the Cheshire Cafe.
So yeah, it's just all over the map. And so I don't know if you can find it. I can't tell you where to get it, but if you see it, get it, because I really like it.
If you see it, snatch it. I'm picturing that little Pepper Jack cheese pretzel growing legs and walking. You're like, last I spotted it was at the Cheshire Cafe, but then other times I've seen it in Animal Kingdom. Like, it's
you
just...
can't catch me. I'm the jalapeno pretzel.
Oh, it was good, though. I'm not even big on spice, and I was like, oh, yeah.
Baby. Yeah, and it's just a little heat, just a little something mm-hmm. on there.
Because sometimes the soft pretzels can be a little like...
Yeah, that was my and my not included. I have any other pretzel. They're just
they're fine. Like when I'm hungry, we've gotten them I think almost at least once on every trip just at some point,
cuz usually as satisfying as I want them to be. They're usually like stale and the salt crystals are way too big, and then like there's salt in the cheese, and like it's just like I don't know. It's enough sodium to fill the ocean.
Interesting.
It's just and it's like and it but it also has no flavor. I don't know how they do it.
That's going to be my complaint about the churros dip, but we'll get there.
We'll get
okay.
there, yeah. Okay.
We promise we'll be more positive. Don't worry, guys.
I
but
promise
it's just
nothing.
Food. It's just food. Okay. Number seven is the Pongu Limp... I knew I would butcher this. Pongu Lumpia. That's what it's called. In It's at Pongu Pongu in Pandora. I went and got a Night Blossom. So good.
That's right, yeah.
And one of these, because I'd heard about it online, naturally, probably on Instagram.
I think you vlogged about this, if I remember it.
I definitely did. And it's basically like a, it's almost like a crepe. I mean, really. But within this crepe is like a cream cheese pineapple filling rolled up, dusted with sugar. It is so, so good. It's weird, though. It's not like something that I would crave all of the time. But like when I'm there, I'm like, I should probably get one of those. Probably go ahead and get one of those. It was so good and so different. And talking about like, you know, obviously you can find pretzels anywhere. You can find Mickey bars anywhere. But this is something very specific to Pandora. At Pongu Pongu. So nice. I recommend the combo of that and a Night Blossom drink. It's non-alcoholic. It is 12 out of 10.
Did I get to try either one of those?
I think I ate them before you got back.
<'Cause>
I'm being honest.
I think I had the girls with me and you got that stuff.
And I ate it all.
Well, good for you.
I'm sure I offered to buy you another one, but then we were like, oh, the line's
long. I'm not
going
back, yeah. So my number seven is... Okay, apparently they're called chicken dumplings. I would have called them like fried wontons. But
yeah.
From Mr. Kamal's in
Animal
Kingdom.
Or empanadas almost, but yeah.
Yeah, they're just these little like fried things. I would not... Anyway, that's what apparently they're called on the menu. They're really good.
Where are they?
At Mr. Kamal's in Animal Kingdom. And mm-hmm. so we had them just this last time. They also had seasoned fries there. We got one of each and they were both really good. I was a big fan of both of those.
Mm-hmm. You digging into some of mine on my list, sir?
Oh.
What's crazy though is we haven't had any repeats yet.
I bet.
I have a feeling some of ours will repeat. Yeah, well.
I bet we'll have one more in common.
Yeah, Mr. Kamal's is a little hidden gem there. I'll talk about it again in a second.
Well, and from, it didn't used to. It used to just be like hot dogs and burgers or whatever.
Yeah,
but recently,
like
I feel like they've changed it to a little bit, you know, different fare. And so that's what this is. And we can actually get some decent food.
I think one thing Disney has done really well in recent years is you've always been able to find things beyond burgers and fries and chicken tenders, although I love all of those things too. But you've always been able to find things beyond that at Disney parks. But really, in the past 5 to 10 years, they have really leaned into realizing that people do want other options. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are staying there more than one day. And so you don't just want hamburgers and chicken all day long.
For a week, yeah.
Yeah, for a week or for a few days. And so I think they've done a good job like things like that, taking a stall that I think you're right. I think it used to just be standard fare like 10 years ago, if it even existed, I guess. But now having it be something more specific to the area-ish and just delicious.
Yeah.
Because then it becomes like a stall that people like, there'll be a line there. Yeah. Everyone knows about Mr. Kamal. So
yeah, it becomes a thing very quickly in today's social media age. Sorry, I keep kicking the table here. I apologize if you're hearing some weird noises.
I am thoroughly annoyed by it.
I know.
I realize how annoyed I was with you. Okay, calm down, Jess. All right. I'm just hungry. No, I'm not. All right, my number six, we can gloss over, the cinnamon roll at Gaston's Tavern. I saw a picture again, and I was like, oh, yeah. I forgot that it is truly covered at the top. Because you know how, like, some cinnamon rolls just don't have enough of the icing. Mm-hmm. So you're like parts of it are dry. So you eat, like, half of it, the good part, and then just leave the other half.
It's all about
this
ratio.
One is absolutely covered on top with topping. So,
for me, the cinnamon roll is made or broken by the cinnamon and butter on the inside of the swirl. The icing, obviously, on top. It's got to be a good ratio. But if you start opening it up and it's all dry, no, thank you. You can just keep that one. You know what? You do me a favor. You eat that one. My number six are any of the crepes, savory or sweet, from La Creperie in France, in Epcot.
Interesting. I wondered how long that would go.
They have this walk-up window, yes? And you can... They have, like, I don't know, four or five savory ones and four or five sweet ones. We've tried pretty much all of them at this point. They're all really good. I think that... What was the one that came with ice cream?
That's the one, y'all. If you're going to do it, do the one with ice cream.
Yeah, that was really good.
If you're going sweet.
But we also got one with
ham,
like,
and cheese.
Ham
one
and
was
Gruyere
crazy good.
Or something like that. That was really good. So that's a good kind of different thing that you can get there from that little walk-up window. They also have the restaurant there, but they also have this walk-up window, and it's, again, something different, and it was good. And they had just, like, standing tables around there, so we went up and got them, and then we just kind of stood there for, you know, 10 minutes or whatever and ate them and then moved on our day.
And it was kind of a nice sweet treat, too. Genevieve was a little bit younger then, and I think we got the ice cream one for her, but, like, we ate most of it because it was melting. Yeah. But they have the crepe that comes with it is just, like, sugar and butter, and it's a really easy, not super messy snack for a young kid that's sweet.
Mm-hmm.
That's all. Okay, my number five. This is going to be a blast from the past. I had to make sure it was still sold, and we are getting it next time we go in a couple months. The caramel ginger ice cream
from Lotus Blossom Cafe
in China. So in Epcot. It, first of all, comes in, like, you know those cups of ice cream you used to get at school where you'd, like, peel off the top?
The paper lid.
That's what it comes in. So it's not even, like, you know, this hand-dipped Wonderment, whatever. No, no. They have that, and they have lychee ice cream, and they still sell both. They are both really good, but the ginger one is definitely my favorite. It is, like, the weirdest, but if you like ginger, it is the weirdest, most delicious flavor. I wish I could find it at the store near us, because... I can taste it so vividly, and that was probably 7 or 8 years ago that we tried it.
Oh, more than that. I mean, it had to have been, like, you and I were first dating.
Yeah.
Like, 2014, yeah. I
like,
remember.
Like, we would just always go in and go to Lotus Blossom Cafe, get their, like, chicken and that. And...
Yeah. I remember that time we were, like, we were both so hungry, and we were, like, but we couldn't decide on what we wanted to eat, and I think we were standing in front of China, and we were, like, okay, there's too many good places. We're just going to go here. We're going to eat.
And turns out that food was delicious.
Yeah, that is.
So that's like a weird one to go back, but go back to that quick service. I'm telling you. Yeah. Also, the food there really is good.
Yeah.
We should try that again.
It's been a minute.
I got to make a list. Yeah.
My number five is the quiche from Léal in France in Epcot. They have. So in Léal, it's. I don't like the way this area is laid out because it's like a little gift shop. I felt like they just had, like, well, here's 100 square feet. Let's fill it with merchandise. And so they had that.
I like that gift shop, though.
And then, like, on the other side, they have, like, a couple tables and stuff like that. But then Léal, and it is a food hall. I guess it kind of makes sense. But anyway, so Léal has this, like, it's a food hall type thing where they have the glass in front of it and they have all different kind of options. The quiche is so good. And a lot of the stuff back there we've had is really, really good. But the quiche stands out, and it's the crust for me. I don't know what they do to that crust. But it is so buttery, flaky crust.
Buttery, flaky, crisp.
It's so good. I gotta figure out what they do. Maybe, I don't know what it is, but it's so good. So highly recommend. They have, like,
quiche Lorraine,
and then with, like, ham and Gruyere, I think, and they have.
That is. No, it's the quiche. Anyway, they have a couple. You can see the menu online. So I'll talk about that in a minute.
Is it on your, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right, my number four. Tyler, judge away. I still love the troll horn at Kringla Bakery there in Norway. I yet again looked at a picture and I was like, yep, it's exactly what I love. So the school bread is a very popular one. And we did get that a couple years ago just to try it again. It's very coconutty. I did like it. I liked it more than you. But I still think the troll horn is the superior thing. But again, you've got to like a cream filling and like a croissant-like crust around it shaped like a horn.
See, that I remember being better than the ones they sell at, like, Kroger.
Wrong. They're both good. But they are, they're obviously slightly different, and I do think probably the ones in Norway are better. But They're delicious. If you haven't tried it and you always get the school bread, I challenge you to try that this next trip you go on. Try the troll horn.
Yeah.
Let me know what you think.
I just don't remember it, really.
Well, we better get it again.
We're going to have to now.
Oh, you know what? I'm pretty sure they actually do have decent coffee selection. I want to look it up and make sure. So in a previous episode we talked about, I was like, gosh, I wish that bakery would be more like coffee shop vibe. Like they would add a bunch more like coffee options. I was looking and I think they actually do have like a decent coffee selection. Let me double check.
Well, while you were looking that up, I'll give you my number four, which is really kind of a cheating one, but coffee. Anywhere, any place, whether it's the Starbucks, whether it's Joffrey's. Oh, I didn't know we weren't doing drinks. Anyway, coffee is my number four because I was thinking about it. I'm like, if I had to pick one snack, one thing to have as I'm walking around the park forever, it's going to be coffee.
Forever.
Forever. If I have to pick one thing, I'm not picking no troll horn.
No, I'm not picking troll horn. I'm picking coffee too. I just didn't know that was an option.
I didn't either, but I was kind of running out of ideas.
Wasn't aware. That's what is a thing that a person could do.
That's good.
Well, we literally can't get our internet to load anything, so I don't know what to tell you. Let's move along. So my number three is quiche at Leal.
Okay.
One thing, again, looking at that menu, there are a lot of things that used to be or like are marked as like snack credit. Not the quiche, but a lot of other like really yummy, savory snacks. So I'll be curious when this is all starting back.
Mm-hmm.
If a lot of those things, so that's something that we'll have to look at, but definitely keep your eye on if you are interested in trying some stuff back there. I think a lot of them count as snacks, so it might be worth,
yeah.
That would be a good use of a snack credit.
I feel like when we, it's been a while since we've been back there, but I feel like most everything is a smaller portion. So I think we would usually get 3-4 plates.
And if we were like planning that for
just share kind of a bunch of different things because they were, you know, you're not going to get a quiche and then be like a meal. I mean, it was a lot of smaller things.
Yeah.
Okay, my number three is ice cream from L'Artisan des Glaces.
Oh, again. This is the France? Third episode in a row we've talked
in
about
Epcot.
It. Gosh. There's a theme of like a lot in France.
Yeah, yeah. It's weird. I feel like the French are like known for their cooking. It's like a thing.
Yeah, it's
for
like
them.
So weird. As you wear your ratatouille shirt. I know. Yes.
Well, I am a classically trained French chef, of course.
That's right.
But yeah, the stuff on Main Street, I think, is also really good. There's mm-hmm. a few other places where they have like dipped or hand-scooped ice cream, mm-hmm. but there's something special about that place. I talked about that recently.
Yeah.
There's just something about that place, man. Didn't you get salted caramel or something like that last time?
Something like that. It was like fleur de sel and caramel, and I'm like, that rhymed.
That was so good.
Yeah, would get it again. Mm-hmm. Again, though, I talk about the salt and straw ice cream, their caramel, whatever. It's like they're different, but like similar vibe. Salt and straw is better. That's the best ice cream I've ever had in my entire life. I would.
I keep hearing
sign
that.
My name next to that.
And I have not tried it yet.
Yeah.
There's been a lot you've
meetings.
Tried without me.
I was very snack focused last trip when we were in meetings. I tried like everything I wanted to.
Good for you.
But now, well, we'll get into your guys' recommendations in a minute. And I'm like, okay, I literally need to make a list because there's so much we haven't tried.
Yeah.
Which is crazy because I feel like we've tried a lot. There's a lot out there.
That would be a fun, like, vloggy video too, like as we're doing trying our like steps. Vlogs and because we're going here soon, but
do
also
separate...
doing like yeah separate video like trying your snack suggestions.
Okay, let's do it.
That'd be fun.
Let's make it happen, Cap'n.
Okay, your number two.
Mr. Kamal's seasoned fries.
Wow, that high up.
They were so good, and we've gotten them a couple times. The dips you can get with it, there's mm-hmm. like one or two, also so good. Oh my gosh, like there's something about those fries when you're just like you're like getting a little hangry, but it's not dinner time yet and you're walking around Animal Kingdom, and as I always say, it's the hottest park, although that area is kind of shaded, but anyway, you walk by and you're like, what's that smell? And you're like, it's Mr. Kamal's seasoned mm-hmm. fries. Those are out of this world.
Gosh,
good.
Yeah.
But I would say if you're going, get both.
Yeah,
because the chicken, not empanadas, what are they, dumplings?
Dumplings, yeah,
the like fried dumplings are so good as well. So I would just get both and sit down and you just all mow, because what's
right.
your number two?
My number two, corn dog nuggets from Casey's Corner.
Ooh.
Those are truly a top tier snack. Now, we've had the hot dogs before. Wasn't a huge fan of just the normal hot dog. Corn dogs are pretty good, but those corn dog nuggets, man, they are top tier food. I mean, I could go to Disney and just eat those.
Yeah. I don't think we've ever done a Disney trip and not gotten corn dog nuggets at some point.
The hardest part is ordering enough that you're full, but not so much that you look like a monster, because I would order, can I get 6 orders of corn dog nuggets? Oh, is that for your family? No,
That's I'll take me. 60 corn dog nuggets. So I did read that there's hand dipped corn dogs. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, like you'd get at the fair. Well, at some of the places in the fair. At Sleepy Hollow. I don't know for sure if it's true. I just kind of saw it in passing and I was like, what? So I like the corn dog nuggets, but they're not on my list. But a hand dipped straight up full on fried corn dog.
I'm weirdly obsessed with corn dogs, though.
Yeah, you're into them. Ugh. I get it, though. They're good.
So good.
We were trying to introduce Genevieve to corn dogs, and she liked it. She actually ate a lot of that one, but she couldn't understand the premise. And I'm like, honey, I barely understand the premise. You just eat it. It's good.
She kept saying, it's a hot dog.
We're like, yeah, honey, but there's like corn meal around, like cornbread, and she's had cornbread, you know, muffins. So she's trying to like, anyway. Okay, number one, should we just, yours has to be the same. Yeah. One, two, three. Spring rolls. Magic Kingdom. I put egg rolls. Because isn't spring like it's like a,
I think it's called the spring roll cart or something like that. Because I looked it up. But they're not spring rolls. They're cheeseburger rolls. Let's be honest.
Well, one of them is, and they always have like one other one. Like one of the ones we've had is like pastrami and whatever. And again, you get dipping sauces that just take it from good to great.
I feel
from great to excellent.
I feel like so often, you know, snacks will get big on like Disney Instagram or Disney Twitter and that kind of stuff, and they never live up to the hype. These exceeded the hype.
Yep.
They're so good.
We used to get a few and share them, and now we just get our own order and sometimes an extra order because we just want more. I can't get enough.
These are for Gigi.
She's not going to eat them.
No.
They're so good. Yeah. So good. If you get one thing at Magic Kingdom, that's it. Yeah.
The cheeseburger one I liked better. You usually like the other one better. The cheeseburger one's definitely a little greasier, but it's so good. Mm. Oh my gosh, they're so good.
That is something, once we discovered them, we usually get them twice each trip.
Yeah. Oh, so good. Okay, so here's a couple things that I thought were interesting that I knew wouldn't be on your list, and they're not on mine. So let's see what's not included. Let's. You can email us your hate mail at... Okay, no. These are going to be some hot takes. Dole Whip was not on either of our lists.
But I like Dole Whip.
I do too.
I have to have it cut with like vanilla ice cream, like the swirl.
Yeah.
Because it, as it is too much.
It's one of those things, pineapple. Like if you get it, I'll have a bite or two, and that's pretty much enough for me.
But I do like it.
Straight, I do too. It's like, but it's the straight Dole Whip. It's a lot. And then I've done a couple other ones where I've done the swirl. I thought I liked the, where they put the pineapple juice in it at once, but that was too much. Like, I don't know. I feel like I can never get it right. It's too much, but I like it, but I'm not going out of my way to
order.
Like,
we don't get it every trip.
No.
In fact, most trips we don't.
Yeah. Again, it's the, you know, you get your picture and then you eat a couple bites. But yeah, the swirl is definitely a tamed down.
Where do they sell the orange swirl? Because that...
I think that's
I had one time and I was like, oh, that was the best version of it. And it's not Dole Whip. It's, you know, but it's like an orange creamsicle flavor.
I think that's in Magic Kingdom.
Or in that area. I feel like every time I've looked for it, I never find it. Maybe they just like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Something else that wasn't on our list were churros.
Churros.
Now, I say that, and I typically get churros each trip, but every time I'm disappointed because I want them to be better, and the chocolate dipping sauce is medium. I just want it to be better.
You know why?
Why?
Because now you've had Disneyland churros, and Disneyland
churros. Because I was like, wait, I had them somewhere. That's where it was.
I don't know what the difference is. I don't know what method. I don't know what supplier. I don't know what is different, but the Disneyland churros are amazing. And the Disney World churros are usually like cold and stale, and the dipping sauce is wrong, and like it's just they're not very good.
That was different.
But Disneyland churros, so good.
You know, we didn't talk about the pickles. We know our buddy Justin, I looked it up and down because he's probably editing this right now. Our buddy Justin Zachman loves the pickle there and always goes, and they are Disneyland people. And did you end up finding a pickle at Disney? I know, this is Disneyland.
Disneyland, yeah.
But even still, just bringing it up because I find it fascinating.
Yeah.
We didn't end up finding your pickle.
I was a sad, rainy, pickle-less man.
That's right.
The Mickey ice cream bar. I think, again, it's good. It's sort of a nostalgic snack, of course. It's like you associate the classic Mickey ice cream bar with being there. But it's just, I mean, they're like the Magnum bars you get at home. They're just like exactly what you get anywhere. Yeah. There's nothing like special about them. And I like them because they're like dark chocolate, and you don't like them because they're too much chocolate, you usually say.
It's like, I can't pinpoint what it is I don't like about it, but I've literally will typically eat a few bites and be like, okay, I'm good. And that's rare because I love ice cream.
Yeah.
So it's something we typically get at least once, whether it's for Genevieve or for you or some mixture of that.
Right. It's like Dole Whip. Like, I like it. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying it's not good, but it's not something that's going to be on my top 10 list.
Mm-hmm. We also did not bring up, other than the caramel corn, popcorn. Your mother loves popcorn. Mm-hmm. And so when we go, she'll typically get some. And if you get like the bucket, you can refill it for like a couple dollars or something like that. Something
and you
cheap.
Get a souvenir.
Okay. And you get the souvenir bucket. Like, we have a couple here that sometimes we'll do a special movie night with the girls, and we'll have popcorn in there. And it's fun. In the realm of snacks, popcorn's not up there.
Yeah, again,
unless it's covered in butter, but they don't have, like, butter stations. That would change everything.
I say, if we have it, I'll eat it. I mean, again, I like it's good, but it's not going to be in my top 10.
Mm-hmm.
The Cheshire Cattail. I feel like that's a big thing that we were both really disappointed in.
I think we should try it again.
Yeah.
Because I think, again, it was one of those days where, like, we got it and it was, like, really dry and stale. And I'm like, I think it was just an off day, and that was the only time we tried it. So I vote next time we go, we split one with some coffee, because I've seen pictures. I'm like, it looks so good and so many people like it. I know it's picture worthy, but still.
Speaking of picture worthy, any of the caramel apples. They are beautiful to look at, terrible for the mouth.
Terrible mouthfeel.
They don't, they're messy to eat. You can't like find the apple in there.
And you're in the heat of Florida,
and then
like
you're eating
just
like
sticky
marshmallow and chocolate chips with your apple, and it's like old caramel, and it's, you can't even like, you're just like mowing on the hard rock that is an apple.
While we're talking about mowing on things, let's talk about the turkey leg. It grosses both of us out. We can't do it. We've never ordered it.
I don't think I've ever seen someone order a turkey leg and be happy with that decision.
It just looks absolutely disgusting to me.
And people don't like them. Every time I talk to somebody, like, yeah, I've had it. It wasn't very good.
But I do think it's almost like a rite of passage that we've still never done. We should try it at least once, but it just...
We should go
with my brother and sister-in-law and make him order one, and then we'll just all try it.
They just look leathery and like, again, it's just chewing on.
And we like meat. Like, it's, you know, not something we don't eat, but just something about that just grosses me out. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. There's always rumors too. It's like, it's actually an ostrich leg. It's always like, there's always like,
you know, that turkey leg you're eating is actually
a hippopotamus
dinosaur.
Leg.
Yeah. What?
Okay. So two more. The cheeseburger, basically bao buns in Satuli Canteen. I loved for the longest time, but the last time we've gotten them, and I've heard this recently from other people too who've tried them, it's now so bready, and there's like a teeny tiny little bit of meat in the middle that now it's just basically all bread,
the
no
ratio's
meat.
The ratio's wrong.
It used to be a lot more meat, and they were so good, but I tried them this last time, and I would agree. So I wouldn't...
Is that considered a snack?
I mean, it is really a meal, I guess, but people consider
you can just get
a snack. I mean, because they're pretty small. I mean, so if you're eating two of those,
maybe you can order like a separate order that versus like the meal with the chips and
right.
the, you know, stuff.
But then what was the other one that I was going to talk about? Oh, Ronto wraps.
Well,
we have
tried
them.
We tried a regular one. We haven't tried the breakfast one, the one. Yes, yes. But I am dying. We are never there early enough to get the breakfast freaking Ronto wrap. I have tried every trip and the day, and it just for whatever reason with the girls and like this, that, and the other, and we have always missed it.
See, I don't even remember trying the regular one though, so it must not have been.
Oh, you know what? I might have tried it while you were at meetings.
Just forget it.
That's what you get for going to meetings? I don't know.
Okay.
So we asked you guys on our Instagram, which is at Disneyville Podcast. Please come give us a follow over there, because that's where, if you would like to be a part of this, like when we're sharing some of your guys's suggestions, memories, favorites, that's how you do it. So on our story, I posted a picture of Tyler eating some egg rolls, and I said, what is your fave snack in WDW? So I looked at this earlier, and I was taking screenshots, and I was like, oh my gosh, there are so many things. So I think I'm literally gonna type a list while we do this of things I want to try next time. So we don't forget.
Okay,
I'll start and we can kind of bounce back and forth. Kaylee Gimme said hazelnut crepes in the France Pavilion. Hazelnut. So are we talking like Nutella type hazelnut? Because that made my mouth water.
Nutella crepes are one of my guilty pleasures. They are so good.
We've made them at home before, and they're so good.
Emily E. Dominguez said tachos. So that was one thing I kept seeing over and over and over again.
I think we've tried them, but I think I'm confusing it with the delicious Woody's Lunchbox.
That's what I think.
Breakfast bowl where it's got tater tots and then eggs and stuff.
Just whatever else is on top.
But the tachos, it's like tater tots, and it's like nachos, but instead of chips. It's
right, exactly. Yeah, with
tater tots.
And
So tachos, those are going on the list. Kendra Barrel said, there's too many. Brioche Ice Cream Sammy in France is the first one that came to mind. A brioche ice cream sandwich.
That sounds
going
ridiculous.
On the list.
Imsterba425 said, a Mickey bar. I don't think it's the best thing there is, but something about the nostalgia. That's exactly it.
Yeah.
It's the nostalgia of the classic Mickey bar.
Totally get it.
But yeah.
And it's same like for me with Dole Whip when we do it. I'm like, oh yeah, I get it. Sierra Hardwick said, the tostadas in Mexico. So I'm assuming it's at the La Cantina like walk-up window. But I love a tostada. That sounds, adding that to the list. I need to sort this by park.
Jason Donahue said, egg rolls, but not Adventureland. The joy of tea booth in China in World Showcase. I didn't even know they sold them there.
Wow.
We'll have to see. We'll have to check those out.
Yeah. Compare. Okay. A lot of people. So this is Fighting for a Cure. She said, at Magic Kingdom, spring rolls and Dole Whip. Hollywood Studios. I almost said high school for HS. Hollywood Studios, Wookiee Cookie, or Pop-Tarts. So those homemade Pop-Tarts at Woody's Lunchbox.
Yeah.
Woody's Lunchbox is one of the greatest additions they added, because for a quick service breakfast option, but then also just their food for like lunch and dinner. But yeah, this Pop-Tart, we've not tried. I'm going to add that to the list. Looks, we'll just have to go and get tachos and the homemade Pop-Tart.
Yep.
They look so good. They usually have like two flavors and I want to try both.
K Trogger 95 said, cheeseburger, egg rolls all day, or does coffee count as a snack?
Okay.
Yes, it does.
Okay, I don't know where this is, but Kay, it's Cassie, said spring roll cart, Cheshire cattail, so there's another one for that, and buffalo chicken chips. I saw a picture of this while I was scrolling through blogs, and I should have written down where it is, so I'm going to add it to my list. It looked really good. It was like chips covered in like buffalo chicken nonsense. It looked really, really good.
Courtney Rose 19 said, egg rolls in China at Epcot. Same thing.
So we've got to try those out.
And she also said Casey's mini corn dogs in Magic Kingdom.
There you go. Yeah. Blossom Girl 08 said, Harambe Market, corn on the cob. I did see a few people mentioning that. I'm just not big. I like corn on the cob, but I usually like if we make it at home, for example, I like shuck the corn off of it once it's cooked and then add butter and kind of mix it in. I'm not a big fan of eating it on the cob. And I think that's a me thing. Like my teeth are too sensitive for it. And you also, I just pictured me biting into a corn and my teeth turning into paper. Like the dream you have,
yeah.
Right?
All your teeth fall out.
All your teeth fall out and they're paper. Okay. Anyone? Colleen Schween said, school bread at Epcot. She was ready. She had one for each park. School bread at Epcot, Pongo Lumpia at Animal Kingdom, which is the one I mentioned, carrot cake cookie at Hollywood Studios, and Nutella waffle at Magic Kingdom.
Okay.
I don't even know where to begin with that.
Faith T Photo said, maple popcorn in Canada. I think that
we've gotten that before.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Oh my gosh, I totally forgot about that. Oh my gosh. Okay, whoa, whoa, whoa. Jandal 15 said, teriyaki bao bun in Japan. That's going on the list.
Oh yeah.
Teriyaki bao, is it bao or bao bun?
I think it's bao bun.
Okay.
I think.
Oh my gosh. You just walk around the world. We get our tostadas in Mexico, our teriyaki bao bun in Japan, get some egg rolls in China, end with the brioche ice cream sammy in France.
Love
Are
it.
You kidding me? Okay, we totally did not mention funnel cake. So Laura Dadson said, funnel cake, we don't have them in the UK, sitting by Sleepy Hollow, looking at the castle. 100%. Like in the morning, maybe you've done a couple rides already and you're like, all right, we're all a little hungry. We want some coffee. Get yourself a funnel cake there at Sleepy Hollow and a coffee, sit. And there's seating there. You're literally looking at the castle. Like that is all of the MK vibes I ever want.
KDH106 said corn dog nuggets. Yes. Any of the spring rolls. Yes. Fries at Deluxe. I'm assuming Deluxe Burger in Disney
those
Springs.
Fries are so good.
But then she said Grave Digger popcorn at Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party. What is that?
I wonder if it's like covered in like sweet, like black and white nonsense, you know? Okay, this one's going on the list. Rebecca Garrow said, noodle gratin from the Germany Pavilion quick serve. We were just talking how we want more there. So I scrolled back a bit because we always share a review and I feel like we've shared a lot of our recent ones, but there were a lot written, you know, a couple months ago early on when we were first starting. So I wanted to go back and snag some of those. So this one is from Jay Lee 123. She said, love y'all. I saved the Animal Kingdom episode for a portion of our drive from Louisiana to Disney World. And Tyler and Jessica were the perfect best friends while my wife and daughter slept in the car. My wife keeps up with Jessica's channel, and their Disney vlogs are always a must-watches for us. Looks like we missed y'all by just a few days during our Disney trip. Running into our favorite Disney adults would have made the trip even better. Thanks for the content. Keep up the great work. That is so awesome. Ugh. One thing we love is when we run into you guys in the parks or, mm-hmm. I mean, wherever. Sometimes we're in Target and someone comes up, which is cool. But always say hi if you see us. A lot of times we'll get a DM later like, I saw you, but I was too nervous to say hi or whatever. A lot of you guys are really sweet. Like, if we're having a moment where we're, like, you know, dealing with our kids and, like, Genevieve's throwing a fit or something, a lot of you guys are gracious enough to be like, hey, I saw you were like, dealing with a lot, but I did see you.
They are nothing like what they act like on YouTube.
I can't believe they're disciplining their kid. No. But you know what I mean. A lot of you guys are very gracious about that. But please, if we're not dealing with our kids, no, I'm kidding. Please feel free to come say hi.
There was one time at a grocery store where we'd been there for so long, and I forget what was, we were like just about to leave, and we had to go all the way to the back to get something else, mm-hmm. and Gigi was freaking, this was a couple years ago, she was mm-hmm. probably 2-3 maybe.
Right in that like
rough and stage. She just starts like screaming, I'm like, Gigi, we have to get one more thing, and then we're gonna go, and she's just screaming, and I said, Gigi, so help me, and then somebody like 2 seconds later comes up and says, hi, we watch your channel, I'm like, I promise.
But it was you saying, Gigi, so help me, finish the sentence, Tyler. Which is and that's the way it goes. That's absolutely the way it goes. But yeah. All right. I think that is fun, all. Though. That was so much fun. We're excited to film some more. We have a very long list of ideas for our next few episodes. These past three episodes, we like knew. Yeah. We planned all at the same time. Like those are definitely the next three. But now we're a little more open-ended, so we need to pick and choose what we want to do next.
I made a list and I was looking at like what we're doing. And I'm like, we have a lot of Walt Disney World episodes coming up. And I'm like, we should throw in a Disneyland one here and there, a Disney Cruise Line one.
I was thinking Castaway Key could be a fun one.
That'd be a fun one.
Because we have been there a lot. Mm-hmm. And before they open this new island eventually and stuff, kind of give our thoughts and overview on Castaway Key. I think
got
that could
tons
be cool.
of b-roll for that too.
And a lot of people, when you're Disney cruising over on this side of America, you're stopping there, so anyway, so we will see what is to come. We have a trip coming up very soon to Disney World. We are mm-hmm. very excited. Of course we'll vlog it as we always do, but
we haven't talked about it on the podcast, but we talked about it on a video on your channel. Mm-hmm. Very, very long story short, we're actually going to Egypt in a couple weeks.
No, when they're watching this, we'll be back.
That's true. We'll already be back by the time this episode goes live. Gosh. But we are going with Adventures by Disney. So that's something we should talk about, is our Adventures by Disney experience. Ooh. Adventures by Disney is a land-based vacation thing.
So like not cruising, but they like, it's like group travel where they plan it all for you, but it's...
Mm-hmm. But it's land-based vacation.
Although say that, and part of this Egypt trip is a Nile River cruise, which is
unreal.
I'm so excited.
So we'll have to talk maybe a little bit more about that that we're
let us know if there's interest.
Back. Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, actually, that's a great idea because I'm going to have a lot to say.
Oh my gosh. I'm going to.
I just know I will be taking notes.
I've already got notes.
Good. The good, the bad, the ugly.
Well, thank you for listening and or watching, and we'll see you guys soon.
Yeah. Bye, guys.